We're going to have our next lecture. He comes all the way from California. This guy, he's one of my personal favorite magicians as far as the material, because a friend of mine in New Orleans fooled the crap out of me with one of his tricks. Not sure if he's going to tip it today or not, but if we don't, if he doesn't, then I hope he fools you guys throughout the course of the convention. Really good guy. He comes again from California, and I think San Francisco area, somewhere in that area. He is a psychiatrist, right?
Psychologist.
It's one of those guys. Something with the head. He's messing with my mind right now. Anyway, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Tom Frank.
Actually, I wore this in honor of John Roderick Armour. It's one of his favorite jackets of mine. I brought it all the way here, and he's not even here. Also, one other thing, when I was under there, I found this. I don't know if any of you guys remember the Lee Asher incident in Florida.
Jesus.
Okay. Well, it's great to be here. Thanks for having me. It's been a couple years since I've lectured, so I'm both excited and nervous. So let's get rolling. I'm going to need someone to assist me, and in a minute I'm going to ask them to do a little poker thing. So is there anybody that's going to assist who's actually versed in poker?
Sure.
If you would, Pete. Give him a chip. Let's get him a big hand. Before we get rolling, I want to draw the attention to the fact that I have four special secret cards here. Keep in mind that they were here before the event began. Before we get rolling, I'm going to utter a few words that will cause all of you to become hypnotized. And as a result of that, you're going to have a false memory of what's about to occur. Brace yourselves. These four places had names. Tyler had fur. All right. If you would, sir, please. Everything feels normal, so if you would just tap. You
reckon?
Probably would. Take a look there. Mm-hmm. Pick up the Sharpie, you can sign. I'm going to say the words once again, and this time I'm going to snap my fingers afterwards. That will bring you out of the trance. Four places had names. Before Tyler had fur. I actually wrote that. There they were, the secret cards. I'll now plop the secret cards into the deck, and they will hopefully find your cover. There they go. Notice the lovely contrast. Into the deck. Trapped a card. Dare I say, your card. They have found your card, and as a bonus effect, they've also managed to erase your signature. Imagine my disappointment. Damn. Stumbling right along. What was your card number?
Four of spades.
Now, you guys remember the secret cards. Four places had names. They were there before Tyler had the pursuit issue. There they were. You showed the four of spades?
That's correct.
That's quite a coincidence, because here we have the four of clubs and the four of diamonds and the four of hearts. What makes this not really coincidental but truly frightening is the fact that you chose this card that wasn't even in the deck. And this is essentially my extension of Brother John Hamilton's signed card. And here's the, you want to stick around? Can you just hang out?
It's okay.
Like a lot of other people, I've recently become a fanatic of No Limit Texas Hold'em. And with that clever segue out of the way, I'll now move over to Marcus for kind assistance. Unlike Texas Hold'em, this is a very specialized game called Well Appointed Stud. I hate myself. The scandalous title refers to the fact that we only use the highest cards of the deck, the tens and higher. So if you would cut the deck right in half and give it your finest, most precise little shuffle. Putting the cards in some unknown order. Okay, I'm just going to use the tens and higher, so let's find them. I won't alter the position of any of the cards. Here's the rules. I'm going to give you the packet. You're going to hold it face down initially. You're first going to deal a face down hold card. You can deal that first card to yourself. You can, well, let me give you all the directions first. So you can deal that first card to yourself. You can deal it for me. It makes no difference. But you have to make the choice blind. And once you make your choice, you can't change your mind. Okay? Then the next four cards to each of us are going to be dealt face up. And you can choose who gets each and every card. After you're all done dealing out cards, you can then switch cards if you wish to. You've got to build the best hand. Okay?
Alright.
So first face down hold cards. Okay?
Very good.
Okay. Stand by. That's good. You're happy with that?
I'm happy.
Change your mind. Alright. Now in stud fashion, you're gonna deal some more cards. So off the top, deal a card face up. Now you want?
Yeah.
You can give me that one, you can take that one, whatever you want. And again, you can always change your mind. Okay? Next. What do you think?
Oh, I'll stay with what I want.
Last opportunity to change your mind to build the best hand that you possibly can.
I have to keep my face down.
Yeah, you can't change your mind.
All right.
So that's it?
This is what I'm going to go with.
Okay. Put those down. So what are you working on here? Three queens and a jack. I'm shooting for a whole card. A bullet. Gotta be three queens. You gave me these cards, remember you chose each and every card that we got. You change your mind as often as you like. Two pairs, see if I can improve. I do with a boat. Thank you very much. they missed.
Wait, we've got to do it again.
Don't you have to wait a few minutes?
Oh my god. That's the first time I've tried that with a male.
Me too, brother, me too. Don't point that my way. Right, so you can withdraw now. All right.
You have total?
Yes.
What's so weird about this is that the total is going to be 162.
Yes.
Isn't that weird? I don't know what you just do, but I think that any Keno card, I mean, this is a great situational thing when you sit around and there are Keno cards. If you fold them up, the whole thing is just fold them. You don't fold the actual paper in half itself. You fold the grid itself. So you have five numbers on this side, five numbers on this side. Fold it in half. And then fold it in half right along the margin that separates the two grids. And if you do that, regardless of where they poke through, when you add up all those four numbers, they're always going to be 162. Hmm. A worthless piece of trivia that might be a I need to use only the highest cards in the deck, and they need to be in order. To wit, the jacks, the queens, the kings, and the aces, or bullets as they're known in gambler's parlance. What I'm going to do is deal them out into a row here and mark each card with a leader card so that you know what's where. Okay? The jacks, the queens, the kings, and the aces. These are the leader cards. These are their minions. And we're working on a royal flush too. These are their minions. In a moment, I'm going to ask you to ponder one of those leader cards and switch it and see if you can get the mates to follow the leader. So ponder the cards for a moment. Decide upon, don't tell me yet, just decide upon one that really excites your nostrils. Have you got that card?
Sure.
Okay. So, let me move these real close. So we have to work together as a team. I'm going to ask you, when you name your card, I'm going to let you switch it with a leader card on either side of it, or one adjacent to it. So for the first time, what is your leader card down to?
I'll go with a queen. See, best for this. Figured we'd follow a theme.
Okay. You can obviously switch the queen with the jack. You can switch the queen with the king. Which one do you prefer?
The jack.
Okay, please come across your fingers. You gotta help me out with this. I do the magical gesture, you provide the magical sound effect. This is the magical gesture. The magical sound effect is doink.
It's
your work. And you spit on it too. And I liked it. We have to be in sync.
Doink.
Did you see him go?
I saw nothing.
It happens really fast. Let's see how you did. Well done. Name another leader card.
The king.
The king. The only adjacent card, of course, is the ace, so go ahead and switch them. Once again, with gusto. Dying. Oh, damn, well done. There are only two leader cards to switch, and even though they're not side by side, I'm feeling lucky. So go ahead and switch them. One last time. There we have it. Perfect matches all around. This is really cool. I got to try this myself. I need a card. 10. Imagine my luck. We swap the 10 with the ace. We'll take the ace and bury it way over here. It's much more difficult now because the cards are further apart and there's a lost in that pack. I'm going to take one last doink. Just like that. Go ahead. Turn those over if you want to. Sweet.
Thanks.
And of course, where are the aces? Well, they're over here. That's good. In the course of a magic performance, a lot of times cards get damaged. They're typically of very little use after that point, but I don't throw them away. I hang on to them. I do that because I'm cheap. Instead of just throwing them away, I try to come up with some kind of creative use for them, some kind of a magical hat. These old beat-up cards, this guy got folded in half lengthwise with his back out, and this guy got folded in half widthwise with his face out. And bringing the two of them together was something very, very interesting that sometimes happens. If I unfold the lengthwise card inside the widthwise card, the back card now becomes face out, etc. My magical brethren, some of them say that a little time tunnel is created inside the card. Some of them say that a wormhole is opened up that causes some bizarre thing to happen. And honestly, I don't know what goes on in there. I don't know how this works. I only know what to do to make it work. And it looks something like this. Fastest through, and the entire card works inside out. Yikes, huh? We can do it again. And the entire card turns inside out. Now I could do this all day long, and actually I do enjoy doing this all day long, But at the end of the day, I'd be left with a car that looks normal. It still has a back, it still has a face. You can't really tell that anything magical has transpired because it looks like a normal car. To remedy that, if we stop the process in mid-warp, we're left with a very, very unusual looking car. And if you're taking pictures, you might want to zoom in on this. And it looks like, oops, I'm sorry, shoot. It looks like this.
I killed him.
I'll get back to this. So, this is damaged, but it might be able to be put some use. This is okay, I can use this in there. Let me try something else with this guy. He's hurting, but I'll do my best. Instead of just having something truly odd, I'm going to try to make something truly impossible. Houdini got to use a curtain, so let me use the back of my hand if you want. A little bit of baseboard surgery. Something that's not only odd, but in fact, truly impossible. And that's Son of Hyperwar. The cool thing about this that I stand by. The cool thing is, isn't that the weirdest thing? And here's the great part about it. After you perform it, you have a little base ready. You mount that card on the base. And ahead of time, you put your contact information on the bottom of the base, and you give this away as the greatest promotional giveaway I've seen in ages. Let your participant keep that, and they will show that to every human being that they meet. And that will generate future gigs. And that is Son of Hyperwar.